Welcome to IHP in Frankfurt Oder. My name is Sebastian and I would like to give you an insight into the IHP Cleanroom. Here we make our microchips and the process requires quite a number of people, equipment and materials from all over the world. In a cleanroom, the environment must be controlled to eliminate all dust. Therefore, before entering a cleanroom, we have to put on special clothing. Gloves, face mask, hood, overall and boots. And now we are ready to start.
Welcome to our IHP cleanroom. It has a size of 1,500 square meters and we operate it for 24 hours a day for 7 days a week. And we need it very clean because every particle everywhere could destroy our integrated circuit because our dimensions are so fine and small. For the production, we have over 100 tools. So let me show you around.
We start with a slice of silicon with a diameter of 200 millimeters. The silicon is incredibly pure. Its structure is in perfect lattice. It undergoes hundreds of manipulations to build up structures layer by layer during the manufacturing process. Let's take a look at some of the first steps of chip production. We can use them as an example to see how the whole process works. To remove surface contaminants such as organics, oxides, particles, and metal impurities, we use a combination of chemicals in the initial wafer cleaning process. A batch of wafers is immersed in a special etch bath for a short time and then rinsed with water. In this section, we have a large variety of equipment using different chemicals not only to clean the wafers, but also to etch away entire layers of different material. To create a pattern, the method of photolithography is used. An optical mask is irradiated with UV light to transfer the geometric design to a photosensitive resist. The first step is to spin coat the resist onto a wafer. This coating technique involves placing a small amount of resist on a substrate. The wafer starts to spin, which spreads the liquid resist over the entire surface, creating a uniform film. The resist-coated wafer and the mask containing the design structures are then loaded into the lithography machine. Once they are aligned to each other, light passes through the mask and the lens system projects the mask 4 times smaller onto the resist. Only one die at a time is exposed to the light, so the whole wafer is fabricated die by die. Once the photoresist has been developed and the exposed parts have been washed away, the rest of the material acts as a mask. The reactive ion etching process is used to transfer the created pattern into the silicon wafer. Reactive ion etching uses a plasma to create ions. These ions react chemically as well as physically with the material to be etched, so they knock off some material to be removed. The advantage of this process is that you can control the etch profile highly precisely. It's a method of choice for creating fine structures. These structures can be visualized with an electron microscope. This helps us to optimize our etching process. Here we see a trench etched into the silicon. Once the structures are created, they can be filled with another material, such as insulating silicon dioxide. This is done by plasma-assisted chemical vapor deposition, which allows a fast deposition at lower temperatures. After filling our structures with silicon dioxide, the surface is uneven and must be leveled. We do this by chemical-mechanical polishing, which combines mechanical abrasion with chemical attack. The wafer is held upside down, pressed against the polishing pad, and rotated with an abrasive slurry in between. We have two different ways to stop the process. One is a blind polishing, so it's stopped by time, and the other method is a stop polishing, so we have a stopping layer where the process stops. The result is an extremely smooth and uniform surface, ready for the next steps. To build our active devices and change the connectivity of our silicon in well-defined areas, ion implantation is a very important method. It involves shooting charged atoms into the silicon. We use boron and arsenic ions for implantation, to name but two. We only need a very small number, like 1 dopant per 100 or 1 dopant per million silicon atoms. It turns the silicon into a p-type or n-type semiconductor. To electrically interconnect our active devices, we use metals such as aluminum and tungsten. For example, a sputtering process allows us to deposit aluminum. This means that an aluminum target is bombarded with charged particles that knock off aluminum atoms. The sputtered material lands on our wafer and forms a conductive film. Using photolithography and reactive ion etching, the film is patterned and the interconnects are created. The processes shown are repeated over and over again to produce our complete integrated circuit. We need over 600 steps for the entire production, which takes about 3 to 6 months. Each wafer is then cut into many small pieces called dies. Dies and related circuitry are chips that make up our modern electronic devices. This is what the microchip manufacturing process in our institute usually looks like. I hope you enjoyed the tour and now have a better understanding of what is happening in the IHP cleanroom.